All right, good job. Hey, if you folks who are watching this aren't done, just push pause and start to play again when you are finished. Here are the check figures that I put up, but let's see how we arrived at these numbers. Okay, on the first five. Right there, okay. Once again, don't just give me the answers, don't just give me a bunch of numbers. Go ahead and label out what you're doing, okay? Now, if you look at those, we're just adding back non-cash expenses, right? So on number three, do we add back rent expense? No, because it is not a non-cash expense. Same thing with advertising expense in number four. Now, number four is a net loss, so our top number is a negative one, right? Okay. Number five, we don't add back salary expense. Salary expense is a cash expense. It was deducted in arriving at net income, and we wanted it to be. Okay? Any questions on any of those? Remember, we are calculating cash flows from operating activities. Any questions? All right, let's go back to the computer then, and let's look at the next category. The next category of things that we're going to do is we are going to add back our losses and subtract out our gains. This category right here. Now, we're going to keep doing this one too, but we're going to also add back our losses and subtract out our gains. Now, some people say, Dave, I think you have that wrong. Don't you mean subtract losses and add back gains? No. We want to add our losses and subtract our gains. And let me give you an example of why, okay? Let's say that we have a truck, and let's say the cost of that truck was $50,000, okay? Well, let's say the accumulated depreciation on that truck is $46,000, okay? And let's say we thought there would be a $4,000 salvage value, so we depreciated down to the salvage value. So that equals $4,000. Do you remember what that equals, what that term is? What is the cost of a fixed asset less the accumulated depreciation? It's the book value. Remember? The book value. So this asset, this truck is on our books at a cost of 50 and the accumulated depreciation is 46. Well, let's say we're driving that truck around for our business and all of a sudden it makes some really, really bad noises and all of a sudden there's smoke coming from the hood and we have to pull over and that thing is not doing well at all. So we get on our cell phone, we call a tow truck, the tow truck pulls it in to their repair shop, we get a ride back to the office and they say they'll call us when they assess the damage. Well, they give us a call and they say, well, I got bad news, right? Have you ever had a car repair person start off with, well, I got bad news for you? That's always going to be a bad day, right? What if they tell you that truck is, oh, you threw some rods and there's just, oh, that truck has a ton of problems. So you ask, well, how much is it going to cost to fix that truck? And they tell you, and it's way more than what you're going to spend. So the truck is dead. Fixed assets don't last forever, do they? You're not going to fix the truck. You can't even sell it in its previous condition or in its current condition. So what you decide to do is you're just going to get rid of the truck. Okay? So you have to make a journal entry to get that truck off of your books. What will that journal entry look like? Well, you're going to credit your truck account for $50,000 to get the cost off the books. Right? Now you need to take the related accumulated depreciation off the books. Well, accumulated depreciation is a credit balance account. Thus, to get it off the books, we have to debit it, in this case, for $47,000. You with me? Well, that journal entry doesn't balance, does it? Okay? We have to debit something for $3,000. Does anybody know what we debit?
How'd you get the 47? Should it be 46?
Yes. I was testing you. This is 46,000. Sorry. I hate when I make mistakes. Okay? but I've made several this year. Okay, let's go back in time. The truck is 50,000. The accumulated depreciation is 46. It has a book value of 4, right? So, what is the journal entry that we have to do to take this truck off the books? Well, we have to credit truck for 50,000, right? We have to debit accumulated depreciation for 46,000, right? Well, that journal entry by itself does not balance, right? So what do we debit for 4,000? Loss on disposal. Well, I told you that whole story. Was there any cash that outflowed in that story? And do you remember what gains and losses are? Gains and losses, gains are kind of like revenues. They're added on the income statement in arriving at net income. Losses are kind of like expenses. They're subtracted in arriving at net income on the income statement. So that loss was subtracted in arriving at our net income number. But it really wasn't a cash outflow, was it? So we have to add that loss back. So what we would do is this. We would say plus loss on disposal. And then we would add, how much was it, 4,000? You see what I'm saying? And if it was a gain, we would subtract it for the same reason, because it wasn't an additional cash inflow, even though on our income statement it was added in arriving at net income. So we add back our losses and subtract out our gains in moving from this income statement accrual number to the net income on a cash basis number. Does this make sense? So now what I want you to do on your handout is do number 6 through 10. Don't move beyond 10, but do number 6 through 10. For you folks who are doing it at home, I will put up the check figures again on the screen for you. Number 6 through 10.